Jim, you guys, through all the challenges last year, had a very successful season with what you did have. Didn't end the way you guys wanted it to. How much of a factor has that been just in terms of what you've seen out of the work ethic of your team and just motivation coming into this year?
Yeah, I think there's a lot of pent up frustration is not the right word. I mean, obviously we were frustrated by the way the season ended, but I think there was a lot left in the tank when the season ended last year. I mean, we had just had a month off and then, you know, basically played for 2 weeks. So I think there's been a lot of letting that feeling marinate over 6 months or so. So I feel like in some respects, you know, these guys want to be unleashed because they were, you know, I think they were having a lot of fun in the way we were playing and feeling pretty good about that. So, yeah, I mean, there's no doubt that there's a level of frustration that I think fuels you. But I think, you know, I've been thinking about this. I've been watching this team over the last month. And, you know, like I just think these guys are happy to get to play hockey 3.5 months sooner or 2.5 months sooner than they did last year. So.
You mentioned unleashing them. You got to do that a little bit this past weekend. You know, what were some of the takeaways for you from the team this past weekend?
You know, getting to see lines play together. We do have a little bit bigger team than we've had in the past. So, like, some of the stuff we can do in practice with full, you know, playing some full ice 5-on-5, we don't always get to do. So we had done a little bit of that. But, you know, typically we don't get our lines going until we start playing games, and that's when they get the most experience. There's limited time to do that in practice. So I think, you know, getting to see us execute and finish nice scoring plays was probably the biggest thing. We know we're going to have to play more defense, and we're going to have to be, battling more than we did last weekend. So I think just getting the sense of flow up and down the ice, getting the lines chances to play together, and to finish the opportunities that we have was probably the best thing that came out of it.
You guys return, I think it's 10 of your top 11 scorers from last year, top two goalies. Where does this team rank in terms of talent that you've had in the time you've been here and just experience?
Well, it's got to be the most experience. We have 8 seniors and 3 grad students, so I think that's... I know in 2017 we had a big senior class also that was the last team to go to the semifinals. You know, I feel like when I answer that, I inevitably insult some other team that thought they were super talented. I think just the level of experience that we have on this team, impact players in all the key positions and depth. I certainly think at the very least, this is by far the deepest and most talented D Corps we've had. We have 3 senior defensemen and a 5th-year defenseman. 2 of them were Hockey East All-Stars last year. 1, Sini Karjalainen, and easily could be. And, you know, like I think with the emergence of Bella Parento as a really, I think, going to be an elite defender in our league and offensive weapon, you know, I feel great about what we have on the back end and obviously bringing back Hockey's Rookie of the Year and that. And I think, you know, I think we have a lot of great pieces up front and we have depth. So I'll let the results speak for themselves about whether this is the most talented team, but it's the most together bought in team we've had since I've been here. And I think it's a joy to be around them, honestly.
How are you managing having a big roster, you know, with the 5th-year eligibility and all that?
It's not so big that, you know, we might have maybe 2 more kids than, maybe only 1 more than we've ever had, probably 2 more than we would normally carry. We do have one of our freshmen redshirting. So, for example, we have 8 defensemen for practice for the first time since I've been here, which really allows us to do more 5-on-5 stuff, to have, like, you know, a little mini scrimmage where you get 4D on each team instead of trying to conserve energy with 3. We've had an injury here or there, so it hasn't really impacted practice greatly. But, you know, I think we've always wanted to have a good, healthy competition for ice time. And, you know, I think with the veteran team that we have, You know, I think we have a nice mix of veterans and younger kids, and it takes a lot of the pressure off the younger players, the freshmen, to not have, you know, to take some time to adjust to it. Last year, one of the best benefits was having that 3.5 months before we played a game for the freshmen to learn how to play college hockey and what the level was, and to learn from the older kids and not have to perform right away like happens now when we're here for 5 weeks and we're playing a game. And so I think it's really nice to have such a veteran team and a great group of captains to show them the way.
What do you know about RPI?
I know that they're scrappy, and you know, like just watching, I think it was a big deal for them to even win their exhibition game against Syracuse. They hadn't won a game 2 years ago the last time they played, and I know they're really hungry for it, and I still don't think that, you know, people look at us and get afraid, frankly. You know, we're going to have to prove something for that to happen, so I'm sure that they look at it as this is their opportunity to come in and get a win. And I think, you know, they didn't play all last year. They got a lot of new players. I mean, they played real games last weekend, which is, you know, puts a lot of there's just not enough practice time, even for us to start this weekend for real. I don't feel like, compared to basketball, it has months of practice time before they play their first game. So I'm sure they're getting better, and they're a little more seasoned at this point than we are. They've just played two real games against Mercyhurst last weekend.
Is there any advantage to, you know, last year it was only conference play? Now, if you didn't see good competition, of course, is there any advantage to seeing some of the other teams on four state have seen maybe in at least 2 years now, at least?
I mean, I think it's nice to be able to get four games under our belt before we play Hockey East. I don't know if it, yeah, I guess I would say that that's somewhat of an advantage. I know that some of the Hockey East teams are opening up with conference games this weekend, you know, and I guess it's a level playing field in that sense that it's their first games. But, you know, those are the games that we're gonna focus on the most. And these are good opportunities for us to measure ourselves against teams of different calibers. You know, I think RPI is going to be a good test for us, and then next weekend Colgate will be an even tougher test.
Where do you think the team has the most room for improvement?
I mean, I think we need to prove that we can consistently finish. Honestly, like, this is a team that, you know, over the last few years, we score in bunches, but then we have some games where we struggle to score. We face a lot of really good goalies, and that can make a huge difference. No matter what the flow or the territorial advantage can be. So I think you know, proving that we can consistently finish our opportunities. We're a team that typically generates a lot of good scoring chances, and I think that's the final piece of the puzzle here. I think, like I talked about, our defensive core, and I feel like our goaltending is strong. But we need to be able to consistently score three goals a game. That's the formula.
Guys, start with six home games. How crucial is it to get off to a good start, just having that advantage?
Yeah, you know, like, I'm not sure I would. I mean, there's pros and cons to it, right? Sometimes you go on a little nice little road trip and you bond and everybody gets away. But you know, I will just say, watching RPI and even a little bit of Colgate already, like, the advantage of playing here, this rink, we love the size of this rink, having deeper corners, a little wider. And I watched some of these other rinks that are small. RPI played at Mercyhurst last week. So I look at that and think that's a huge advantage for us, to know our rink and to understand angles and how we like to play in the offensive zone, move the puck, and our style of play. I think getting off to a good start is really important. I mean, we have 2 years ago, we got off to a real good start and didn't sustain it. Last year, I think the first weekend we split, and then we went on a pretty good run, but that was split up by, you know, taking a month off, which really, you know, split the whole season in two, the short season in two. So, look, I think it would be great for us to take advantage of the opportunity that we have in front of us, but I think more than anything, playing well and getting the results that we want is, wherever it would be, is the most important thing.